everybody, how's it going? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Megan. I make videos each week on healthy living and simple living, and today's video is all about self-care habits that we can do each day to help us feel our best. And self-care habits and routines look different for everybody, but one thing that we do all share in common is that we all need and we all deserve to take care of ourselves and to have some self-care, because when we do, when we feel our best, we're able to show up in the best way possible for our family and for our friends and at our jobs. And, you know, life just works a little bit smoother. It goes a little bit smoother when we are really taking care of ourselves on a regular basis. So let's get started. My first self-care habit is very simple. It's a very basic one, and that is to go for a walk. Going for walks regularly is one of my favorite things to do because it's relatively easy to do, doesn't cost anything, and it always feels so good. Walking for a lot of people too is almost like a form of meditation, especially if you can get yourself out into some nature, whether you know you live by a body of water or near a forest or a park, if you can be around some trees, and you know, just putting in some headphones, listening to some music if you want, or nothing at all, right? Just listening to the sounds that are around you is such a fantastic way for us to calm our mind and calm our bodies. Habit number two is to put your phone away or turn off the TV while you're eating. The reason why this is so important is because we're able to digest our food better when we are limited our distractions, when we're able to be present with the food that's in front of us, but we're also able to enjoy the conversations with the people that we may be eating dinner with. I have a whole video up on intuitive eating as well that talks a little bit more about this. I'll leave a link to it below. A lot of times in the evenings when we're getting ready for bed, we tend to do it really quickly. We tend to quickly wash our face if we're wearing makeup that day, or we tend to really quickly brush our teeth and then hop into bed. And I think we can often associate doing those sorts of tasks with being really boring or tedious, and we just want to get them over with. But we can actually take that few minutes of when we're getting ready for bed and turning it into something that's very relaxing and kind of calming for us. So something that I like to do is I'll take a hot cloth and I'll rest it over my face, and I'll, you know, really thoroughly remove my makeup, and then I'll apply my favorite moisturizing oils on my face. I'll leave some links below to a couple of my favorite moisturizing oils. A lot of you guys ask me about my skincare routine and the things that I like to use on my face, so I will leave some links below. But I'll really take a few minutes to just, you know, massage those oils into my face and turn it into like a miniature pampering routine. It doesn't have to take long, even if it's just 5 or 10 minutes, where you can really just make this something kind of relaxing and take your time with it. Floss, brush your teeth, kind of try to enjoy it instead of rushing through it and then hopping into bed. Habit number four is to take a time out for yourself. I know that all of us have a ton of responsibility, and sometimes we have to carve out the time for ourselves, and you just kind of have to do your best to make it work. Really reflect on what feels good for you. What can you do? What kind of time out can you take for yourself, even if it's just for a short period of time? And do things that make you feel good. Having a hot cup of tea, or running yourself a hot bath, or phoning up a friend and having a good conversation, or having a good laugh, or getting creative. And you know what? Sometimes taking a time out is also none of those things at all, but just not doing much at all. Really, just stopping for a moment. I think that a lot of us need that sometimes. Habit number five is to eat your greens every day with at least one meal a day. Greens are so important for us to eat regularly because they're a fantastic source of chlorophyll, which is great for our digestive tract. They're also such a rich source of minerals like magnesium and calcium. This is anything from just, you know, a spring mix to different kinds of lettuces or kale or spinach or broccoli. I want to share with you some really easy ways that you can incorporate more greens into your diet and into your day-to-day regime. So for breakfast, greens are super easy to add to a smoothie. This is a classic. Green smoothies are excellent and very easy to kind of hide the flavor of greens with fruit, banana, mango, pineapple, or berries. Throw some spinach into your smoothie, you won't even notice. You can also saute up some greens with some eggs, scrambled eggs, an omelet. etc. For lunch, you can have just a good old classic salad. Dinner, greens are so easy to add to soups, stews, stir fries, into pasta sauces as well. Throw some collard greens or some kale into your spaghetti sauce. I often will do that. And for a snack, you can make something like kale chips. I love kale chips, really easy to toast up in the oven. I have a whole video up on some healthy snack ideas that I will leave linked below, including how to make kale chips, so check that out. Habit number 6 is to create boundaries for yourself. Creating boundaries for ourselves is really, really important. And that's because when we don't have boundaries, we welcome more stress into our life and we welcome more uncomfortable situations because, you know, we're not identifying what's too much for us. It's important to honor what you will and will not accept. Start by just simply identifying the things that tend to cause you a lot of stress and go from there. This might be taking on too much responsibility or, you know, certain people are taking advantage of you or asking too much of you. It's important to be assertive sometimes. That's often, you know, how we are able to set boundaries, is having that assertiveness, which definitely takes practice, but there are opportunities in our life all the time where we can practice, you know, setting those boundaries and executing those boundaries and being assertive, but being respectful. And my last habit is to stimulate your brain. So I know that when we think about self-care, we often think about slowing down and doing less, which is something that I've talked a little bit about in this video. But stimulating your brain is also important as well in different ways, in more positive ways, such as learning something new, watching an interesting documentary or reading an interesting book or article, having interesting conversations, taking a different route to work, walking through a different neighborhood, seeing new things. When we're able to do these sort of different things, we're able to stimulate our brain. And it's really easy to kind of get stuck in the same day-to-day routines where we get up, we go to work, we come home, we have dinner, we go to bed, and we do the same thing again and again. But when we're able to switch things up, learn something new, do something different, we're able to actually support our brain health, our cognitive function, have much better mental acuity. We can think better, think sharper when we are stimulating our brain and learning something new and kind of creating new neurological pathways in our brain, which is super fascinating to me. So those are all of the self-care habits that I wanted to share with you all today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave me a comment below with some of your favorite self-care habits, and I will see you very, very soon.